Hi there. So I recently did a tutorial about an Excel beta that can help you keep leading zeros from disappearing. And this led to some questions about, well, how do I access these beta tests? Well, the first thing to consider is if beta testing is even right for you. So if you like trying new things and you don't mind using features that haven't yet been fully rolled out, or even worse, get removed, then you're a candidate. So if this is you, the next key thing that you need is to have a subscription to a version of Office 365. This is because Office 365 is always online. So not just can you get your files from anywhere with an internet connection, but also Microsoft pushes updates and new features to its 365 subscribers, including if you allow access to some betas. So why do I say some? Well, to avoid total meltdown, betas get rolled out gradually. This means that even if you follow all of the steps to set yourself up to test betas, you may still have to wait a little bit longer than someone else. So what are the steps? So if you already have Microsoft 365 running, open any one of your Office programs. So this is an Excel channel, so I'm going to be doing this in Excel. So open Excel and go to the Account tab. If you already have a sheet open, like I do here, go to your File menu, then click on the Account tab. Once here, click on the Office Insider button, then click on Join Office Insider. So to proceed, you'll need to check off this box giving Microsoft permission to give you early access to new features. And you're not done quite yet. So within the Office Insider program are different channels. And by default, you're going to be in the preview channel. This channel is the one that gets you the early access to fully rolled out features. But to be eligible for betas, you have to switch to the beta channel. Again, and I can't stress this enough, there is some risk with this. The beta features may be buggy or they may even get discontinued. So if you're okay with all this, then select this channel. And it's a good idea to check for updates, so you should keep this checked off. But if you want to check for updates later, then uncheck it, agree to the terms and conditions, and click OK. And now we wait for Microsoft to do its thing. And that's it. Thanks for watching, and for more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.